Australia is opening its arms to victims of the latest asylum seeker tragedy.
The first injured survivors are arriving on Christmas Island, but many others are now feared lost at sea.
TENS political editor Hugh Riminton is in Canberra. Hugh, is the rescue effort still on?
It is, Bill, but I've got no good news to report. No one has been found alive in daylight hours today. All of those who were saved, including a 14-year-old boy, were rescued during desperate scenes during the night. Today, there has been nothing but bodies found floating in the sea and empty life jackets.
The first of 109 known survivors, Afghan males, some injured, are brought ashore at Christmas Island. Some 90 others are still missing.
We do face considerable loss of life at sea.
The boat first reported difficulties just off the Indonesian coast on Tuesday night, but it was still moving and fatally kept heading south.
It was 38 nautical miles when AMSA told it to turn back to Indonesia, and it was over 100 nautical miles south of Indonesia when we found it capsized.
The Prime Minister was with Indonesia's president in Brazil as the news came through, the government detailing a desperate all-night rescue effort involving two naval patrol boats, aircraft and merchant ships.
People can survive out there for up to 36 hours if they have either life jackets or they have debris to hold on to.
At the moment, all the focus is on rescuing people who are drowning at sea.
A terrible, terrible tragedy, and our hearts go out to everyone affected by it.
This disaster was entirely predictable. It had, in fact, been predicted as long as the political impasse remains over border protection policy. Both sides say this is not a day for politics, but Tony Abbott couldn't resist entirely.
We did have a solution some years ago, and that was the great achievement of the Howard government.
The government still wants its Malaysia solution. The opposition and the Greens have blocked it. The UN High Commissioner for Refugees today urged Australia to do more to discourage dangerous and exploitative journeys at sea.
And one Liberal Party backbencher, Dr. Mal Washer from Western Australia, says the public has had a gutful of the lack of political cooperation to resolve the issues. He says what we've seen today was foreseeable and is unacceptable. He says we've got to go beyond the simplistic dumb and dumber competition between the Malaysia solution and the Nauru solution. He says if that means the Liberal Party getting on board with the Malaysia solution, whatever it takes.
Hugh Riminton in Canberra, thank you.